Welcome to the last stream of the weekend, the women's final here at the Sydney Melbourne Open 2017. Brought to you by Yukon Discs. We've got Ellipsis in white against Bauhaus Elite in the brown slash blue slash dark brown black.
Bit of everything.
Yeah, a bit of everything. A little bit of orange mixed in there. Look, these two teams have done quite well moving through the rounds. I'm not sure if they've played each other yet, but Bauhaus Elite coming through the semi-finals against Rogue Block. Ellipsis coming through the semi-finals against Rogue Rage. Hashtag all the rage. Game starting with Ellipsis on O.
So Georgian Egan Griffiths picked it up, and we've gone to Cersei up the line here to Mangan. In the middle there, Georgian Egan Griffiths. Nice floaty one coming out the back there. Caroline Ma jumps it in. Or not. No.
The signal from the game goal. Advisors is goal.
Goal has been signalled. So first goal to Ellipsis quite quickly too.
So it's a testing weekend, this type of weekend. So there's a lot of games. It's hot, we've had cold, we've had windy. It's got to test
very
the
players.
Very hot
at the moment. Oh dear.
It's not as much recovery time as you'd get at a tournament like Nationals. Players are going to find that a little bit difficult to adjust to. In the last game of the finals, we saw a lot of attrition. Talking to the Hoss boys after they were struggling physically to the end of the game.
Yeah, and it was just super hot and the wind was picking up and it was really making it hard for these players to play their best ultimate, really. So hopefully, I mean, the wind's died down just a little bit. Hopefully the players will be able to show us some really great ultimate here.
Bauhaus, of course, a really good mix of experience and younger players. You hear names called that have been called across the world in different tournaments, and names that haven't been called yet anywhere.
Yeah, that's right. Well, actually, it's pretty the same for Ellipsis too. A mix of really experienced and also.
Maylin Shua to Birchall. She looks down the field. There's a poachy defence against him. Back to Maylin Shua, gaining a few metres. She looks to the end zone.
It's a turnover. Just went too far for the player it was intended for. So Tiffany Chow here picking up the disc for Ellipsis. Getting it to Alex Prentice in the middle. Just a call made there.
That's a foul signaled, uncontested.
Foul. So they'll just work out what the count was. So Prentice with the disc there. Into the middle there to Kelly McLeod. Back to Prentice. Up the line to Dignam. And she sends it long. Intention was Rebecca Brereton there, but just a little bit too far.
Birchall's walking towards the disc. Huge backhand. Would not be surprised to see an early long one put up.
Saw a lot of that this morning, so I'm waiting for it.
Michelle Phillips first Brereton. There's a contest I'd love to see. She winds on the forehand. And there it goes.
Here we go.
The contest we asked for a second ago. Phillips considers whether the contact affected. Good defence from Brereton.
Chow picking up for Ellipsis. Over to Prentice. Just fumbles out of her hand. I'm not sure.
Cox will be happy with that. A lot of pressure on the receiver. Birchall flips it over the top two. Mumford, who bunts it up and is unable to collect the disc.
So Ellipsis will be trying to settle into their gameplay here. Chow with the disc. Cross to Prentice.
Big
round. Just jumped out of her hand, but she's run after it and got it. Zips it through the middle there to Brereton. To Chow. up and around, looking for Nat Ray there. We find Nat Ray to Dingham. Dingham. And it's just turned over.
It's a quick turnover and quick transition. Travel called.
Rubenberg there, just helping the players discuss what's happened in that situation and come to a conclusion so that the game can continue. So the players now deciding where they're actually going to start the disc after that.
It's been quite a break in the game. The discussion's still happening.
Ruben's coming out again. Yep. Means they've been talking too long. Finally, a decision's been made, and it will start with Mish Phillips.
Contested on that travel.
Yeah, contested travel.
Shell Phillips with disc in hand, moves it on to Birchall, looks down the field, just looking for a dump, engaged, it's a crowded area. The big forehand goes up out of panic. Seo and Michelle Phillips there in the, oh, huge grab from Phillips. Incredible read, as graceful as you'd like. Chua to Seo.
Great and work there by Mish Phillips and Bauhaus. Unfortunate there for Rebecca Brereton. Just ended up on the wrong side. Okay, so we're just now from Ruben there. We've got the call was a travel that was contested but then reinforced. Retracted, sorry. And then they decided to recall it. So, bit of confusion out there, and good thing that we've got Ruben and the game advisors on board here to help out in situations like that. Okay, so Bauhaus are on defense, so Shue Gross there will have the pull to start this point. And Ellipsis will get ready to receive on offense. Okay, here we go. So, Cersei picking up the disc. This is Jessica Cersei. To Caroline Ma. Sends it up the sideline there to Sally Yu. Takes a great grab there. She's looking to centre it again across to Caroline Ma, who goes to Jess Cersei. Back to Caroline. She sends it over to the other side to Lauren Tink. Lauren Tink just a slight fumble in the air there. Body wasn't quite in the right direction to grab that one safely.
Lucy Stevenson bringing the disc in from the end zone line. She puts it up in the air to the advantage of Gross. Safe hands there. That's who you want receiving that disc. And she looks down the field. It's not much to throw to, but she finds eventually the cutter down the space. Cortez has the disc, looks down the field, swinging, eventually finds a dump to Gross. The big swing around the ponytail goes flying. Hammer across the field. Floats. and it's disposed of by the Ellipsis defender.
Okay, so Jess Cessy here picking up for Ellipsis. It's in the middle of the field, just looking for her options. Caroline Maher comes out, grabs the disc. Looking, she's trying to get it back to Jess, she does, to Cessy. So Cessy up the line there to Ash Martens. She flings it long there. It's coming down, a few players in the way. Unfortunately, Ellipsis were unable to communicate that one. Turn again though, however. That was a very quick there turn from Bearhouse. So Ellipsis are walking up. Jess Cersei will pick up the disc again. Ellipsis are in a vertical stack. She sends it long. And Sally Yu takes it. So a score there for Ellipsis. Jess Cersei to Sally Yu.
Fairly frantic transition from Bauhaus.
That was. It was very fast. It was too fast for me to even know what happened, really.
Yeah. looking to move the disc. And before we know it, Ellipsis have another shot at the end zone.
It's very hot here on the grounds. We're on an AstroTurf surface, so the heat is absorbed very well into the surface, so it's very hot. Even as a commentator on the sideline, it's quite hot, so I can't imagine how they're going out there.
Toasty. Big thanks also to our cameraman on the main camera and two individual cameras who have stood there in the sun all day. Done a fantastic job.
A lot of effort goes into bringing this broadcast, so it's we're very lucky to be able to have all these people working together.
Big thanks to Mike Palmer for heading up the operation.
Lira Meehan with the pull for Ellipsis as they run down on defence.
Bauhaus with the disc in the centre with Birchall. There's a lot of space in the middle of the field. Paddock, and somehow it finds Gross, who passes off to Chua. An old, old connection there. They've been playing together for a long time. And a fantastic pass, the around pass to Zach Phillips in the end zone.
The Bauhaus celebration that we know so well, we actually get to see it there. So great to see those girls getting around each other.
And fair enough too, fantastic offense. That pass really opening up the floaty backhand down the middle.
Yeah.
Somehow evaded any defenders and ended up in a offensive player's hands. Em, do you know the reasons behind that celebration? Like the origins?
I think from my experience of playing when it was Team Box, that the club itself is a very... they have lots of cheers and they have lots of ways to celebrate, and it's in those critical moments where you could be looking at the play and it could seem like just an ordinary type situation where they've got the goal and it didn't look like too much effort, but they really celebrate the effortlessness of when they can pull off what they've been trying at training. And it's, yeah, they a good indication is when Mish Phillips gets, you know, you can see that she's really excited and she's got that determined look on her face, and they all kind of get into that group and finish that with a cheer. So that's what we've just seen from Bauhaus. So they're pretty excited about how they've started, and they're pretty pumped up, I'd say, to get the next few points out of the way. So it'll be interesting to see how Ellipsis responds to that. They know that Bauhaus are on game at the moment, so looking forward to see how they respond. So just a bit more discussion time happening between both teams. They obviously want to make the most of their next move. Okay, so Bauhaus with the pull there. Ellipsis getting ready to pick up on offense. Jess Searcy across to Lauren Tink. Bauhaus have got a defensive wall happening here. Back to Jess and up the line there. Very quick passes there. We're with Hannah Mangan. She's moving it up there. Ash Martens. And across somewhat easily, but then a layout there by Jess Searcy. So fantastic to see a new player to the club really making her mark in this tournament.
What a response to Bauhaus's quick offense last point.
Yeah, so, I mean, it can go one of two ways. And Ellipsis have held their own game plan and they've put it forward and they've got the point from that. So, and Bauhaus won't drop their determination on based on that one point. They will get right back into this.
So she's been a real asset to that team today. I think she's played fantastically in the first game we watched as well.
Yeah, absolutely. She's definitely been a strong handler. She's made the right decisions where she needs to. She's fitting in really well with this team.
I can't remember a throwaway with that wind either.
No, I can't. No, she's played brilliantly. So it looks like Ellipsis are doing a bit of a match-up. They're looking a lot over at the Bauhaus team and sorting out who's going to play against who for this next point. Okay, Lyra Meehan with the pull for Ellipsis.
Disc hangs and just shifts itself over towards the sideline. Birchall picks up the disc. There's not many options. She's a little bit stuck. Saucount will be getting higher. She's going to wheel onto that forehand. Look for Sarah.
Oh no. Wow. I didn't know what was going to happen then.
That's can't see who the receiver was behind the crowd.
I don't think the receiver knew that they were the receiver at that stage. That was one of those moments where you just don't know how it happened. Hopefully we can see some replay here in a moment. Fantastic effort there by Bauhaus.
Oh, look, that's if you get to Storkan 8, 9, whatever that Birchall was on, that's the optimal result.
You don't have much of an option. Here's the replay here. It's a bit of confusion. Oh, dear.
And the back edge of the disc as well. Looks like Cassie Chan there with the receive.
Great work there, Cassie. So the scores are tight, 3-3. We like nothing less than a tight battle between these two phenomenal women's clubs from Melbourne.
Would like nothing more?
Nothing more. That's it, sorry. My bad. Nothing more. Okay, so the disc has come down. Ellipsis to pick up. Jess Searcy with the disc. Over to Egan Griffiths. Who looks again for Searcy. Nothing there, so she clears out. We've got Miriam with the disc here. She's gone to Caroline Maher. Back to Egan Griffiths. To Caroline Maher. Griffiths. To Maher. Egan Griffiths. To Martins, and she puts it up and over, waiting for it to come down, and it's knocked out of the way there by a Bauhaus player. I don't know if that was Mish Phillips or Shuey there.
So this line from Bauhaus, very similar to the ones that have been playing downwind. They've switched it up quite a lot. Potentially looking for a bit more control.
Yeah.
I'd call it a more experienced line.
Possibly. I think whatever can give you the upper hand early in the game is it's makes it easier mentally, physically to get going with the rest of it. Crystal
flying
Chung there with the D for ellipsis. So Jess Searcy picking up. Out to Egan Griffiths. She's looking. Caroline Maher comes in to help. Up and over. And we've got Miriam Vino with the score there for ellipsis.
That's 4-3. And it's the advantage of ellipsis. We're essentially going with the downwind at the moment. How long ago was it that you were playing with Team Box?
Let me think. Last season was ellipsis, and then must have been the season before I was with Team Box. And I had a break at some stage. I think I played 3 or 4 seasons with Team Box, with a break in there at some stage. So, yeah, phenomenal group of women, really supportive and really looking to help those young players come through. Especially, obviously, it's a women's club, but focusing on those young women and trying to get them to where they want to go with Ultimate, whether it be world level or whether it just be club level or even just the, you know, the weekly kind of Albert Park League situation. So whatever you want to do, you're very supported in that club. Okay, disc is going up here, Leah Romain for ellipsis, and it's coming down for Bauhaus offense.
Birchall picks up the disc, moves it to, is that Mumford? Back to Birchall. Oh, there's absolute panic in the middle of the field. Looking to get the disc to Maylin Shaw, but kind of a thrower initiated into the space.
Bauhaus players were very, very spread out in that play there.
All the room that Shaw wanted.
So Tiffany Chow here picking up for ellipsis. She's looking for her options. Nothing coming. Alex Prentice there. It's been a call here. Foul. Uncontested. So Prentice with the disc. She quickly moves it off to Brereton. Again with that Phillips Brereton matchup there. Just out of reach there for Meehan.
Mumford with a disc in hand. Big around to Birchall. Maylin Shaw will have to go at the scraps. McLeod getting in the way.
Great work there by Kelly McLeod. So ellipsis once again in possession of the disc with Chow coming up to the sideline here. Very tight defense here from Bauhaus with Alex Prentice here in the middle. And Mish Phillips has just come through on Rebecca Brereton to get that defense there.
The closing speed from Phillips.
Yeah. Phenomenal.
She's already having a big impact on this game. I know that sounds silly to say. She does normally, but we're really seeing her wares on this game. Birchall's trying to get off that line of strongly, so the high forehand goes up.
Whoa. And great grab there by Brereton. She's got it at the front of the end zone there. Over to Alex Prentice. And Trenwith has just been intercepted there.
Sano getting in the way. Maylin Shaw with the hammer. Unable to connect.
So both teams having a bit of trouble here being able to get the goal. whether it's the start of, well, we're kind of not really at the start of the game anymore, looking at the scores either. So just trying to figure out how they're going to get through. Lips is here with Tiffany Chow. She looks across field there to Alex Prentice. Picks that one up. She's upfield there to Shannon Trenwith. Into the middle, Lyra Meehan. Alex Prentice up to Lyra again. She goes long. What has she got there? Unfortunately, not. No option there.
Birchall picks up the disc quickly and it wants to go long. There's not really much movement. It's not really much of a dump either. So she's a little bit stuck. There's only a mark getting onto her now, so really is the that's why it's taken
very,
she has
very
all the time.
Spread.
Maylin Shua reads that a little bit, but then it keeps on going.
The wind is...
I thought it was going to come down and land on her, but it just
yeah,
kept
it
on
just
going.
Kept going. So this point is turning into quite a long one for these players, and they'll be really feeling it out there on the field, knowing that this is the last game of a two-day tournament. Chow picking up. Oh, close one there. Prentice picked up and went to Trenwith, and then just...
Ray not able to reel that one in. It's just on the fingertips. Mumford with the high forehand. Blades and blades.
So, Ellipsis, I think for the fourth or fifth time now, we'll try and bring this back to the other end from their end zone.
Might notice six players in the vertical stack for Ellipsis. Maybe a little bit different to standard what we're used to. It'll be interesting to see how they use that. As I say, that Trenwith falls back.
They've just miscommunicated. So, Chow with the disc. She gets it up the line there to Prentice looked long and then stopped. Over to Trenwith. Up to Nat Ray. Goes over and a bit of collision there, and unfortunately, I don't know. The disc has ended up on the ground because it was an interception there between the two players. It's a Bauhaus disc.
I'd love to see the replay. It looked like she had control of it.
Yeah, I thought she had too, but...
Birchall puts up the forehand. Michelle Phillips with the read.
Fantastic work there by Bauhaus. Long, long, long point for these ladies out there.
Timeout called.
The ladies on that line look absolutely exhausted from both sides. It's really tough out there.
Bauhaus very keen for their huck game.
Yeah.
Just going to keep on keep on going to the well on that one.
We've seen that from some other teams today as well. So we're thankful here for Ruben Berg, who is game advising today. He's also got Mary Toney out there with him, who is learning about game advising and hoping to become quite skilled and good at doing it so that she can be a part of that game advisor team. And if you're listening at home or if you want to know more about that, please contact Ultimate Victoria or Ultimate Australia. They're always keen to share their knowledge. And if you've got an interest in game advising, please put your name forward because we'd love to get some more out there.
If you've been following today, you might have seen the change in the weather.
Yeah, it's we've constantly changing out here, isn't it?
Rain to sun to wind. Ruben Berg reminding us that interesting hit in the middle.
Yeah, with the two Ellipsis players.
I think Brereton looked up to call a foul, and realising it was her teammate.
Her own teammate.
A bit of confusion in that moment. Ended up with the disc being a turnover.
Hard situation though when the disc is coming down and it's, you know, being affected by the wind, and it becomes really hard to read, especially if it's coming down into a pack situation. So, I mean, doesn't always happen, but you do have those times where two players from the same team will actually not realise that they're both there and end up a drop has happened because of that.
Yeah, if there's going to be a collision in alternates, generally
yeah.
then.
Yeah. So, Bauhaus on defence with Ellipsis to play offence for this point. So again, both teams kind of taking their time to set up what they're going to do for this point. Looks like we can expect to see some man defense from Bauhaus.
Definitely taking their time on this line.
Yeah. Okay, disc is coming down. Jess Searcy picking up, and she goes long straight away. See who's on the other end of that. Sally, you had a go at it, just a little bit too high. So Bauhaus to pick up.
Miriam Vinot walking to the line, her older sister playing in the opposition team at the moment.
Oh, taken out of the air there by Jess Searcy. She passes to Hannah Mangan. So Ellipsis possession here. Over to Ma. Who goes back to Searcy. She's looking for her options there. Into Mangan. Very close to the end zone now. And nice straight pass across there to Ash Martins for the catch. So Ellipsis take that point. To make it 5-4, Ellipsis' way.
So after playing for both teams, you're not finding your allegiance going either way?
No, look, I think, you know, when you play Ultimate, you build friendships, and the friendships, I feel like, last forever. And it's it's great to have, obviously, my most recent team, Ellipsis, and it was really great to go through the establishment of a new club, and especially a new women's club within the Ellipsis branding, and great experience. But also, I wouldn't be the player I am today without Bauhaus and what I learnt from them with Team Box. So I started off initially with Squadron, which is a team that aligns closely with Team Box, and fantastic, just supportive group of women in both respects. So I think if you're a Melbourne female and you're up and coming player, either one of these clubs will be great for you. Okay, so Bauhaus on the offence here.
Birchall with the disc, and she moves to the centre to Mumford. That's a connection we've seen a few times today. Yeah. It's a jump defence thrown. Is that a disc to Stevenson? Trying to get the breakout. Eventually finds the space. Birchall to Phillips.
So Hayley Tan there.
Birchall's throwing, moving up behind every disc.
Ah, oh, lovely.
Somehow finds Hayley Tan standing on her own in the end zone.
Hayley Tan is one of those up-and-coming players. We're going to watch this space. She's quick. She takes unbelievable grabs that you expect people not to get. yeah, she's a phenomenal young player coming up. So Bauhaus pretty happy with that one.
Putting out there on the Bauhaus roster, there seems to be a direct correlation between height and years of experience. Don't know how that's happened.
So much experience in both of these teams.
So Maylin Chua, one of those that we speak of with disc in hand. Played with Ushua in the Groundhog Day teams.
Oh, APL. Groundhog, yes.
The stalwart of the Division 1 and 2 and 3 now, there for a long time, with Maylin Chua there as well, and Karen Baker, many of these women.
So, Jess Cersei picking up there for Ellipsis. They have got a little bit of a zone happening here. Back to Hannah Mangan. Up to Ash Martins. Over the top there to Vino, and then back to Mar and Vino and Mar. And passing it up, and unfortunately Sally Yu has just made a drop there. Bauhaus have quickly picked that one up.
Chua with the disc in hand. She wants the backhand, but the defender is in the way. Really looking aggressive in her stance there, wanting to move the disc forward, but unable to. The high backhand sits. Chua. What is that? Gross has time. My apologies. She puts a very high flick up. That's going to sail and say Ash Martins is underneath it, and I never really bet against her. I think it was just confusion in the end. I'm not. Yep. General confusion, I'm calling that.
Okay, so Cersei into the middle there with Martins. To Mangan, to Ma, to Mangan. Ooh. I think she might have been troubled there, just saying.
And I think she knew that.
She pulled up pretty quick.
Pulled up the run backwards.
She just got on a roll and didn't want to stop.
She may have even caught it on herself.
So disc is with Mangan into Ma. Martens. Mangan. Up to Sally Yu. Over to Ma. Martens. Mangan. Ma. Anyone else with a different lettered surname want to get in on this? Here we go. It's a great D there by Laura Cortez. Bauhaus picking up.
The around forehand finds Gross on the end zone line. She looks for the forehand. It's not really on. It's a pretty crowded end zone. She pushes it to Karen Baker, who gets an apologetic shove. I took it as apology, but... And it is. That's that score stands.
Crystal. Shoving some people around, was she?
That's the first score to that end in a very long time.
Yeah, it is actually.
The wind has died off, it's worth mentioning. And they've taken advantage. Who knows if she'll be back? The downfield offense looked so comfortable for Ellipsis. Yeah. They looked in control. Before that, that hand just got in Martin's way.
Yeah, no, it did look really good.
And Bauhaus, yeah, respond and get the score that they've been after, that upwind. Well, upwind end, not that it's blowing right now.
So... Scores are Bauhaus 6, Ellipsis 5, so only 1 point behind, and a great final so far. Both teams taking a little bit of time to get ready for this next point. With Bauhaus will be on defence, so with the pull, and Ellipsis on offence. Okay, Mikaela Dignam there picking up the disc. Straight into Tiffany Chow. Across to Maria Chow. Alex Prentice to Lyra Meehan, who picks up a great one. And just a little bit of confusion going through there, trying to get it to Shannon Trenwith, but not quite.
Chow with disc in hand. Cocks the wrist, looking for the forehand. And then shoots it. Not afraid to shoot.
Not afraid to shoot, no.
And that one, unfortunately, yeah, it just has a bit more vitreous gas on it.
So Chow with the disc. Bring it up to the end line, end zone line. Sends it across to Maria Chow. Back to Tiffany Chow. Mikaela Dignam, quick movement through there, back to Chow. Looking for, thought she was going to Prentice, but eventually gets to Prentice. Oh, and just hand fumble there, or a little tip from the defender.
Birchall on the end zone line. She'd be really hoping that this should be an easy put away. Dubs to Maylin Shaw, who puts the disc out in front of Tony Cox. Makes no mistake with that. That's a score. They follow up their break with the score. They take an advantage. Is that 7-5?
Bauhaus will be pretty happy with that. 1 point away now from half-time. They're able to score the next one. So at this stage of the game, Ellipsis don't want to be getting too far behind in the scores. We do still have basically half a time to go. So we'll see what happens.
Got a really exciting contest here. It's
It always is when these two clubs come together.
And,
you never know.
I would love to know what's happened in the placing game for 3-4, how that's going.
Yeah, rogue versus rogue.
Rogue versus rogue, yep.
Okay, so Ellipsis getting ready here on offense. Jess Cersei picking up, looking for someone to come back. She goes up the line to Sally Yu, unfortunately, just with a drop there.
A couple of drops that are really hurting Ellipsis at the moment. Karen, is that Karen Baker?
It is.
Karen, she changed her hat.
possibly. Great little defense there. There's been a call.
Let's look to the player advisors. Foul called. Game advisors, not player advisors.
The discussion is between Jess Cersei and Kath Matthews there. Just unsure about that D that Jess was part of.
That's a contested foul. So the disc will be returned.
Disc is coming in on 3.
Disc is in. Karen looks across the field to Cortez, who looks to Gross. pumps the forehand downfield. Looking to Sano, who is outrun by Cersei.
Hey, Cersei back in the middle there to Georgia Egan Griffiths. Over to the sideline with Crystal. Back to Georgia. Over to Marion Vino. Ash Martens. Jess Cersei. And she sends it long. Hoping for Lauren Tink, but not quite within her reach there.
Tink unable to reel that in. Quite the put. Miriam Vino brings the disc in to Gross. She fakes down the line, looks and eventually throws to Kath Matthews, who's run through by Jess Cersei.
So Georgia Egan Griffiths walking up to pick up the disc for Ellipsis, not far out of their end zone here. Puts it straight to Ash Martens, and we have a goal for Ellipsis.
That was a bullet for that last one.
Just wanted to get it there. So we're on 7-6, Bauhaus with the lead at the moment. Remembering that the halftime is at 8, so first team to 8, and that's our halftime. Beautiful replay there of Egan Griffiths to Martens for that score. So just getting ready for this next point. Lyra Meehan with the disc ready for the pull from Ellipsis. And Bauhaus getting ready for the offense. Just about ready.
This offense line.
Great pull there by Lyra.
Oh, Bauhaus, we got to. Who's picking up the disc there? Is that Hotan across to Birchall, to Phillips, who throws it across. Unable to be reeled in.
Okay, Ellipsis in control now. Chow with the disc, looking to get it off that sideline. Swings across to Chow. Nat Ray. Back to Maria Chow. Over to Tiffany Chow. Back to Maria. Across there to Nat Ray. Back into the middle, Tiffany Chow. Maria. Trenwith. Chow. And Lyra Meehan, with a bit of a tumble, picks up that point there for Ellipsis.
Fantastic play from Ellipsis. They got given the disc in their attacking half and took advantage. Found the space.
So we're in the situation now where whichever team scores the next point will be the team that takes half. So both teams will be wanting that. It's just a nice way to start the second half, but knowing that you're just 1 point ahead. It's So lots of discussion happening on both ends here.
Whoa. I saw it, it definitely happened.
That's 7-7. 7-7.
It's
a point to go to half. Just going to go with the advantage.
Okay, looking ready to go. Ellipsis with the pull.
Birch with the disc. She's looking to force it to the centre. Not having a lot of luck so far.
Pick has been called. I think it's all been sorted now, so.
Gans finds, is that Cortez?
Oops.
Strip or foul?
Stevenson there, we've got with the disc.
Sorry, Stevenson. Uncontested. Stevenson looking down the line, but just no option there. Birch, no, that's Karen Baker coming across. Finds Madeline Shearer in the centre. Big gainer who puts it up to Gross up in the air.
Mundy versus Mundy there in that in the end zone. Panamangan and Shue, both representative Mundys, the last campaign.
Sure, they trained together plenty of times.
Oh, yeah. Know each other very well. Ceci picking up. Great little bullet there up the sideline to Lauren Tink. But there's been a call. Travel. The travel has been called with Jess. So she'll just get the disc back and we'll start from there. Disc is coming in on two. Across to the other side of the field, Egan Griffiths to Ma. Back to Egan Griffiths. Just a nice little Bauhaus defense there.
Sano getting herself in the way, making that catch hard to take.
Great work.
Birchall with the pickup, looking long very early. She looks to Chua. Oh, and follows up and unable to grab the bobble.
Okay, so Ceci picking up for Ellipsis. Looking at her options, goes back to Ma, sends it across the field to Vino, to Egan Griffiths, back over to Ma. Ceci, and we're back on this side of the field here with Egan Griffiths. Ceci, Egan Griffiths to Ma. We're hearing that combination pretty frequently. Egan Griffiths sends it up the line. Ash Martens with the nice layout there to grab that. Back to Egan Griffiths. Switches it over to the other side here with Caroline Ma. She looks for her option. She's found one. And it's Lauren Tink that takes that point.
And that takes Ellipsis and Bauhaus to half with that score.
Fantastic effort there. Lots of highlights there. Ash Martens laying out for that disc to ensure it kept in Ellipsis' possession. And then some nice passes to get it over to one sideline. Fantastic effort to both teams there.
Absolute UConn Discs play of the day nomination right there. Love that layout. Huge, great height from Ash Mountains.
Passing over now to Matt Hill, who's in the centre of the field.
We're good. Halftime here, the women's final. Very close game between Bauhaus Elite and Melbourne Ellipsis. Melbourne Ellipsis just taking half there. I've got Say with me. Say is here all the way from China. And he's come down because he's a co-founder of UConn Discs. And they've been the major sponsor for us here at SMO 2017. So Say, tell us about UConn Discs. How did you start the company? How did it come about?
We started the UConn Discs 9 years ago. And when we were students in a Sino-British university, and we make professional discs, gear, and accessories.
Fantastic. Now you've got the Ulti Pro here, the Yakun disc, the Premier Ultima disc. It's just got WIFDIF championship approval, is that correct?
Yes. And it's our 44 generations.
44th generation disc. So it's a lot of testing has gone to come up with the ultimate product here. And you've also got a jersey. Show us this one. You're wearing one, but you've got this one here. So the winners of the final now, when in one more half to go, will walk away with these championship shirts. Spin around the other side. There we go. Made by Yakun. Mammoth just got theirs for winning the men's final. They were asking lots of questions. They were very happy with the product. So if you're interested in getting new shirts or want some new discs for your club, check out Yakun discs. Yeah. And tell us, why did you come all the way from China for this tournament?
Because lots of clubs and teams use our products. I think it's good to be here and make friends with clubs and engage with the organization teams. And they sell our products, promote our products.
Yeah. Fantastic. Well, we've really enjoyed having you here with us this weekend, Say, and thanks a lot. This live stream is only possible because of Yakun's major sponsorship. We wouldn't have been able to afford to do it otherwise. So thanks to Yakun, you're being able to watch this live. So thanks a lot, Say, and enjoy the rest of the final. Back to you in the studio.
Hill and Say, back here in the studio.
Our studio is definitely the place to be today. Beautiful setting.
The power lines of Epping.
Yeah, that's it.
In the distance, on the horizon. At least the sunny weather isn't as boiling hot as it was about an hour ago. It's got to be easier for the girls running around the AstroTurf.
We get all sorts of weather here. It's been so hot today. It's been raining today. We get it all here. Replaying that awesome layout there, Ash Martins, to get that disc to make sure it stayed in play for Ellipsis. So Ellipsis up 1 point, so we're at 8-7. Ellipsis against Bauhaus in the SMO women's final here today. So both teams getting ready to start this second half here.
Call this wind a little bit more of a cross breeze than downfield.
Yeah.
Bauhaus with the advantageous end to start and on offense. So it'll be up to them to convert that. Ellipsis, of course, is going to be on all over that, going to come out firing. They're going to want that D really early.
Yeah.
I think I'm not sure we've given quite enough praise to his Prentice.
Prentice
today. This weekend I've been really impressed by her, the amount she's had the disc in her hand and really how safe and attacking she's been all at the same time.
There's a partnership that I miss watching, and it's, I think it's because they've been put on different lines, but Georgia Egan-Griffiths and Alex Prentice.
Yep.
Are a phenomenal force. So I'm actually missing not seeing them playing together on the same line. But yeah, Prentice, very a steady handler. It'd be nice to see her take some of those longer shots sometimes, though. She's a safety player, and I think she does a really great job of that. I'd like to see her take some risk, I reckon, sometimes.
Seen her pierce that cup a couple of times, but I think you're right. A couple more attacking throws.
Yeah.
That cup working very hard on defence and puts it up long to Michelle Phillips, who's read it.
Oh, it's just slipped out of her hands there. Just went under.
Prentice checks she's okay. That was coming in fast and was coming in on the angle, so it was always going to be a hard grab. And if anyone's going to take it, it's going to be Michelle Phillips. But she's not able to pull it down.
So Ellipsis now are in possession. Chow picking up. Just right in the center, perfect positioning, over to Prentice. Goes up there to Brereton, back to Prentice, now on Prim. Out to Kelly McLeod, back to Prentice. Phillips, great defense there. She moves up the line again to Maria Chow, who goes up and can't quite find her downfield play there. So Bearhouse picking up. Stevenson.
Stevenson dumps it to Birchall. Looks downfield. That zone's slowly falling into place. Finds Mumford on the far wing. Straight into the hands, straight out to Birchall.
So Ellipsis now with another opportunity. They're well over halfway towards their end zone. Chow picking up to Dingham. Back to Chow. Looking. She's gone over the top with a hammer intention, Brereton, but unfortunately it was just outside of her reach there.
Stevenson looks down the line. I'm not sure she was ever going to actually throw that. The mark is nice and tight there. And
ow, McLeod.
McLeod steps in the way.
Dumps it back. Chow.
And it finds the hands of Dignam.
Great work there by Kelly McLeod. She saw that disc coming in and she took that opportunity to grab it out of the air. Two easy throws and they were in for a point. Or perhaps not. It's just some discussion happening out there. Ruben's involved. Perhaps the players are moving away off the field, which indicates that perhaps the play is not actually over.
Whatever the call, it came in fairly late.
It did.
We still have two coaches standing on the field. That's how late it came.
So somewhere along the line, someone's decided that they wanted to say something about what's happened. And we're just trying to work out what that was.
Contested. Contested down. So, it looks like that disc will return. Maybe
right.
If we're able to see a replay, we see the disc released pretty low. Clearly up on the replay.
I don't know if she had control of it though. I think that might have been.
Do you think that might be the issue?
Just at that point there, I don't know whether she'd.
Potentially.
If she had control, it wouldn't have slipped further out of her hand.
Yeah, I was looking for the contact of the ground first, but maybe it's the control.
It's a hard one, especially to decide in such a split second.
You can't see what her grip was on the disc at that point.
No, it's very hard. So it's back to Chow, who's now just
run through Sullivan.
Pulling over each other. Oh. So uncontested. Foul, I'm assuming. So Chow still with the disc. Ellipsis need to clean up where they're standing. Brereton just grabs it ahead of Tony Cox there from Bearhouse. So Ellipsis with that score.
Taking the score, if I know those girls, I think that call will do will just fire them up.
Yeah, I think definitely won't put them on the back foot.
So timeout called by the Bauhaus girls. Bauhaus want to take some time to recollect.
Yeah, it's always a tough one there. Call's been made. And having it so close to the end zone too, it's harder and harder to get that time to get a turnover. Great shot there of both teams in their team huddle. reassessing, looking at where they are at and how they're going to go forward.
With the grassy hill beauty of Epping in the background. Epping, for those watching at home, interstate, 40 to an hour north of Melbourne. Still technically Melbourne. It'll count for Melbourne hosting the tournament. Just giving that little bit of an advantage to those northern people coming down.
Yeah.
Feeling a little bit more at home.
Couple of Hoss boys are playing some paper, scissors, rock. They think they're on camera, but they're currently not. So
it's a very classic.
I won't tell them that.
I won't say classic. That says it goes for years before this, but this year tradition for the Hoss boys to pull out a bit of paper, scissors, rock at any timeout.
Oh, interesting. Because that was a big team box thing. I don't know if they still do it at Bauhaus, but there was a paper, scissors, rock game invented for each year that the club has been in existence. I don't know if they've continued that going into it being known as Bauhaus, but there's at least, well, I don't know how old Team Box is, but what, nearly 10 years of different paper, scissors, rock games.
Trust me, the Hoss boys are not that creative.
Yeah.
There is absolutely zero chance of that.
Right, so final couple of words before this game keeps going on, getting underway here.
Yeah.
So Ellipsis 9, Bauhaus 7. Got about 15 minutes or just under 15 minutes.
So a big point that we raised coming out of half was that Ellipsis was going to have to take that that downwind advantage off Bauhaus.
Yeah.
Did that first shot.
So looking
don't worry
pretty
about
strong.
That.
Ash Marsans with the pull there.
Big pull.
Great pull. Bauhaus. Shue. Oh, man, Hannah.
Big beard.
Mangan getting on the ground. Martin's had a bit on that one too. Great defense here by Ellipsis. Fantastic defense. I think Hannah Mangan laid out two times in that point, doing all she can to get back in possession. Cersei picking up. Straight up the line there to Lauren Tink, who goes to Sally Yu, back to Tink. And there's, I've just realised there's been a call up the back where we started from. Not sure what the call was. We'll have a look at the game advisors and see. Still unclear. It's sending it back to Lauren Tink.
Even that seems a bit confused now.
There's lots of people talking on the field at the moment, trying to work out where they're starting, what's happened. Okay, I think they've decided to keep it with Lauren Tink on the far sideline. Right, so Sally Yu in possession now. Swings it across there to Cersei, to Ma. Over the top to Martens. It goes just through the middle. Wasn't enough speed on that to get it through before the defender came. So Tan, Hayley Tan here with the disc for Bauhaus. Birchall just tipped her hand and fell to the ground. So Ellipsis edging closer here to their end zone. Cersei picking up, swings across to Ash Martens. Goes to the middle to Hannah Mangan, who just picks it up. And nice quick and easy pass into their Caroline Maher there. So Ellipsis with a score to get them to 10 against Bauhaus 7.
Had a couple of calls come into the game the last few points.
Yeah.
Long discussions on them as well.
I didn't think it was a treble. I gave my advice. Yeah, I said it was too close for us to tell. Even on the camera.
Okay, so getting ready for the next point. Ellipsis will be on defense, and Rebecca Brereton is pulling, and Bauhaus is ready on offense. Stevenson there. So, Ellipsis getting ready to pick up the disc. Maria Chow picking up for Ellipsis here, bringing it to the front of the end zone. Pretty close to that far corner there. Sending it across to Prentice. Sends it up to Brereton, to Nat Ray. Chow, Prentice. Chow. Dignam couldn't quite keep hold of that one. Great pressure there. Fantastic effort there from Michaela. Maria Chow picking up for Ellipsis. Exploring our options, out to Prentice. Prentice looking for someone. Kelly McLeod comes forward. Brereton almost getting confused there with Dignam. Into the middle there for Nat Ray. Alex Prentice, she sends it. It's up, it's floaty, it's coming down. And Mish Phillips has just got in on that.
We see that contest between Mish Phillips and Rebecca Brereton again.
Still going.
I love that. It's not too surprising. Two of the tall receivers for each team battling it out a few times in this game.
Great to see Prentice putting that one up there. Awesome effort.
I'm really gunning for the big huck from Birchall to Phillips on this one. She's on the upwind side this time. Probably hoping that disc doesn't float over her head. Will this disc float back enough? Off the Mac.
Phillips is waiting for it.
It's optimistic. I would have liked it, but no go.
So Maria Chow picking up the disc here for Ellipsis. Edging closer to the end zone. She's looking. There's a pick called. So before she even moves too much further.
Just did.
Okay, So we've sorted ourselves out here. Chow sends it up. Prentice. Nat Ray.
Fantastic score for Ellipsis. From Prentice.
Starting to really roll with this now. We're up to the 75-minute mark, so not too much longer left in this game.
The fantastic thing with Ellipsis is pretty even effort. You know, there's a lot of contributors, a lot of people are gonna who they can drive through. We see that fantastic grab from Prentice. Down low around the ankles. And through to Nat Ray.
Prentice has great control. She's really centres herself. Strong passes. She really considers her options before she makes them too.
If you notice the game time clock, roughly 3 minutes or so left in the game. Quite the margin though, 11-7. And we are playing a hard time cap. Got the jewel pink socks of Stevenson and Cortez on the offensive line for Bauhaus.
Here we go, Ellipsis running down really hard on this defense here. Unfortunate drop there by Ingrid Vino. Ellipsis picking up Ceci across to Ma. And straight into Crystal for the point there for Ellipsis to bring them to 12.
Energy is a little bit lower at the moment. Bauhaus, their coach potentially has a response to that called timeout. Tournament director has instructed them it is within the last 5 minutes of the game and therefore timeouts cannot be called.
Let's forget about that rule. So it's play on.
Quickly back
to the
line.
Get ready for the next point. So time between points is not usually this lenient. I've just heard the buzzer, so I'm guessing because they're on the line that this is, they will have to play this point because technically if you're on the line, you're signaling the start of the point to come. So we will play this point. This stage, Ellipsis have got the win today, but whether they finish on 13 or remain on 12 will be decided now. Lyra Meehan with the pull, and Bauhaus ready for the offense.
Karen Baker jumping out of the way of the disc. Maylin Shewitt onto KB. Stevenson with the disc.
Stood a drop there by Bauhaus, unfortunately. So Tiffany Chow coming up. Swings across to Kelly McLeod. He waits for her to come back. Chow with the disc here. Hard defense there by Maylin. Goes across the field to Nat Ray. Chow back across the field there, looking for Shannon Trentworth. Unfortunately, it's just a little bit too long and gone out of field, but there is a call, an injury call, one of the Bauhaus players there in the middle of the field, so not sure if that happened before or after. Unfortunately, it doesn't look great out there. Okay, so we have got word it's not serious. It's just a bad cramp there with Shue. So she'll probably move herself off the field and try and stretch that one out and be replaced by one of her teammates. Not uncommon for that to happen at the end of a tournament, two-day tournament. These ladies are playing three, if not four, games a day. It does take a toll on the body, so Shue just coming off the field there with a cramp in her calf by the looks of it. And Mihatch is taking over her position there. So it remains a turnover because whatever happened there did not affect the play. So Bauhaus will pick up the disc and bring it to the sideline. So Lucy Stevenson looking to pick up that disc and take it from the sideline. So Stevenson back into the middle to Matthews. Back across to Stevenson. Matthews comes around the back there to receive the disc off Stevenson. Back to Stevenson. And she puts it up, looking for Chua, which she takes it down. Back to Mihatch. Across to Stevenson. Chua looks long. She's put it up, trying to get it in there to Michelle Phillips. And there is a call there between Phillips and Brereton. But they've decided it was indeed a turnover. So Ellipsis back in control of the disc here. Chow picking up. To Meehan. Back across to Chow. Over to Maria Chow. Looking for back to Tiffany Chow, who had to lay out there in order to keep the disc alive for Ellipsis. Back across the field to Meehan. She's looking long, but decided to go into Trenwith. Up to McLeod. Back across to Trenwith. She goes long. Meehan's on the end of it. Just tipped out of the way by Phillips. And Bauhaus are back in possession. Phillips picks it up very quickly across to Baker. And intention was Cox, but it was just a little bit too high and out of her line that she was running in. So Ellipsis again have possession on the sideline. They're very close to their end zone, probably about 15 to 20 metres away. The wind is picking up. It's making it incredibly hard for these players to keep on task of what they're trying to do here. Chow to Chow. Into Meehan. Looking for an option to Maria Chow there. Back across to Meehan. There has been a call indicating that the disc has hit the ground. Ruben's going over to have a look, discuss what he thinks he saw. And from that replay, it's really too close to tell, because having control matters a lot in Ultimate. So Meehan with the disc here. And she's sending it back over to Maria Chow there. and play will start from that position there. So Matthew's just making sure that her team and everyone else is ready. She checks it in. Maria Chow to Brereton. Just goes straight through there. Chua picks it up for Bearhouse. She sends it. Hoping for Mihatch, but not quite getting there. So Ellipsis coming right back here. They're way back over halfway at the moment. Maria Chow picking up the disc on the sideline, calling for her teammates to come in a bit closer. Over to Meehan. Tiffany Chow. Over. Oh, couldn't quite get it to Meehan there. Mihatch picks it up for Bauhaus. She's indicating she wants someone to come around to the other side. She goes to Phillips. It's just out of Phillips's reach there. So Ellipsis starting again basically where they were before, 20 metres out from their end zone on the sideline. Chow to pick up, Tiffany Chow to pick up. Meehan makes an early cut and it's just then gone past her. I think both teams are a little bit nervous at this moment. Over to Chua from Baker. Back to Baker. She sends it through to Cox, just dips over her head. Phillips grabs it. And there'll be some discussion about whether that was down or up. Phillips is asking. Most are saying that it was down, so there is a turnover there. Very, very, very close. So Chow picking up now, and I think that was the right call, it was down. Over to Brereton for Ellipsis. Across to McLeod, and again it's just slightly offline of where that player can grab it. Stevenson from Bauhaus picking up. Sends it through to Matthews. She's looking at Phillips in the background but not sending it at this stage. Baker on the far side there. Sends it up. Ah, wonderful. And Rach Mihatch takes that last goal there for Bauhaus. Fantastic effort there. That does bring us to the end of the game. Due to the siren going to indicate the end of the game at the start of this point. So after all of that, there's just the replay there. Great
interview with you.
Grab there from Mihatch. So it is
game,
an Ellipsis win here today.
Affected it. Got your goals out of the weekend.
Yep.
All that kind of stuff. Yeah. They're going to be just looking at this camera up here.
Yeah.
So they're...
stream here. Thank you to the sponsors for allowing this live stream to happen. The camera crew and everyone who's involved in putting this together. It is a big process and we're very grateful that we've got this able to happen so that the fans out there can see what's happening in Australian Ultimate. So this is SMO, Sydney Melbourne Open. And Ellipsis are the winners of the women's division here. Thank you very much for listening. This is Emily Atoni signing off for today.
Well, here we have the assistant coach with Ellipsis, the winning team today. Now, Chuck, have you got what you wanted to out of the weekend so far?
Yeah, absolutely. So it's been a really great weekend. I think we really wanted to use this tournament just to work together as a team. And we definitely got to run through a lot of points with playing with each other and playing with our structures. So really solidifying those structures. So it's been an amazing weekend. Thank you to the sponsor, Yukun Sports.
So Chuck, the wind picked up probably, you know, halfway into the game, really. Looked like a factor from the commentary box. How about for the players?
Yeah, so definitely some trying conditions, but I think we really drilled in that we still need to play Ellipsis Ultimate, so we pride ourselves on playing 100% Ultimate, and look, it wasn't exactly 100%, but I think the girls did really, really well in just lifting that standard and playing, sticking to our structures even in really trying conditions.
Sure, and from this weekend, the road to Nationals, are you looking forward to that? What's that going to look like?
Yeah, absolutely. So BCI in a few weeks, so looking forward to playing yet another tournament. It'll be good to get some of our other players back too. Not sure if you've heard of Kat Phillips, number 35. She plays in the Australian Football League. You should look it up. It's a really good sport. It's an up-and-coming sport.
Absolutely, and it'll be great to have her back. What a pickup, really. Thank you very much for joining us, Chuck, and congratulations again.
Great.